So what is the topic? I know, why the? Page 1, 3. Write down. Take out your copies too.
Copies are
written. I told you to make two copies, now copy 1, copy 2. So bring out copy 2.
Not good.
I know. Silence, one thing first you look at. The title written in your book, I know. Why the kids got things? It should be written like this. Clear? Only articles and pronouns to be written using small letters. Otherwise, all the others should be beginning with caps. Clear? First, you notice this one. So when you write the Merchant of Venice, what should be capital? The D capital. Merchant M capital. Venice B capital. Should of be capital? That's a preposition. That cannot be capital. So immediately a question comes, who's the I here? What does he or she know? And what she knows about the page part, who's the page part? Why does he seem? The title itself is the summary for the poem. Okay. Every topic does not come like this. What is the importance of title? Chief Seattle speech, will it come? What is the significance of the title? Will not, no? Just like television, what is the significance of the title? This type of titles do not have any significance. Title is like the engine of a of a train. What does the engine do? Pull the train, no? By seeing the engine, you can understand it's going to be a huge size train. A tractor engine will not pull the train. Similarly, yes, sir. You cannot see both. Okay. So, if it comes, what is the significance of title for any topic? Okay. So, one term you have to memorize. You have to use that one. We must write down. Title encapsulates 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 encapsulates. The thematic pattern of the entire topic. Thematic, thematic, of the entire topic. Thematic. Thematic, theme, thematic. Why are you not writing? Huh? Yes, your copy is submitted. Wait. The entire topic. By seeing the title, you can understand little bit about the topic. Just like the heart of the tree. Out of syllabus last year. Have you checked this year's syllabus? Go to the website cisc.org. Surprise is here for you. Lost chapters are added. Chapters which were excluded got included again. So you have to study again. Clear? So, just like heart of the tree, you can easily understand. The heart of human does what? Comes the blood. So out of the trees, what does what? Pumps oxygen out, is it? So one connection you can draw when listening to one title. And in fact, this poem is not that good as the title. So I use the poet or poetess? You will not be writing poetess, you will be writing poet only. There is no more heroine, there is no more actress. Okay? Nowadays, to reduce the discrimination, what is done? These are many feminine and masculine gender are reduced to common gender. Got it? Hero is no more of masculine gender, it is a common gender. Actor, poet, nowadays, presently, these are common because we don't use separately. So you will be writing poet only. No need to write poetess. So the poetess knows what? She knows why the cage bird sings. Why does the cage bird sing? What is the natural thing? What is the thought that we have, natural thought we have associated with the bird? Unless the bird is a penguin. Basically, what the birds do? Fly. Except few birds, most of the birds fly. So birds normally fly. And if it does not fly, it can run fast, is it? But when a bird is inside the cage, what can the bird do? Can a bird fly? Can a bird run? He can hop inside the cage. Hopping means, you know, some of the jumping like this. Sit down. So, a bird inside cage does not live the life of a bird. So, what the bird does? Sings. Are songs always happy? Melancholic also. So, the cage bird sings a melancholic song. So where it is written, sings that down a melancholic song. Don't write that song, melancholic. A-V-L-A-N, melancholic, L-I-C, melancholic song. But why does he sing? Why does the bird sing melancholic song? Because he lacks freedom. He cannot fly, cannot run. Only thing what he can do? He can sing his pain out, is it? Since all the other freedoms are, write down, since all other freedoms are absent, so he sings. So he things. Written over. So it is a poem that reflects two particular community. During 16th century, the Africans were, many Africans were taken to America with the assurance that they will be provided with proper health system and education and social security. Was that promise kept? No. They got transformed into slaves. Slaves mean workers who work without any payment. Without any payment. So they used to work without any payment, number one. They used to live the life like the domesticated animals, just like a cow or a mule or a horse. Only for food they used to work. To what they lived, that was not a human life. That was a painful inhuman life. What they lived was not a human life, instead a domesticated life, just like an animal. Their legs used to stay tied or enchained. The owners used, what they used? they used chains, and those chains were tied to their feet along with a certain amount of weight, so that they should not do what? Run away. Children were kept in particular area, particular camp, and they were taught how to be perfect slaves. This way they lived their life. They did not have any family, proper life or anything. And we all know, living a life is what? Living a meaningful life is our fundamental right. That means birthright. When we are born, that means we are free to live a life, at least. That is the most important freedom. They do not have freedom of choice also. So here the poet is lived, or the poet lived same type of life. She belonged to the Afro-American community. The poet herself belonged to the Afro-American community. She suffered, and more than that, more than suffering, she herself is the what? Cage bomb. She herself is the cage bomb. Okay. So who are the cage birds? The Afro-American community. So whenever you are going to see in your book that it is written cage bird, you should know that this is Afro-American. And when you see white bird or tree bird, that is the white people of America. The poem will be far easier if you have read the story. If you have read the story, Chief Seattle Speech. Okay. But you did not study this one since it was out of topic last year. Okay, we'll study that one, don't worry. One of the hardest stories, but most interesting one also. First line, what is written? You stand up. Yes. And read the first line. Cage bird leaps. Leaps mean what? Okay. Whose book? His book? Your book?
Mine.
Okay, next. On the back of the wind. Back of the wind means? Okay. A free bird flies. At the back of the wind stands for? Center Ministry. You are not sitting in the parliament. Huh? Yes? Okay. No. Acknowledge the river. Right now. By flipping the wings against the wind. By flipping the wings against the wind. And floats downstream. Why is it that floats? Why don't fly? Downstream stands for along with the stream or river. You can write river later also. But how long does he fly? Till the what is written?
Current
ends. Till the stream or the river gets submerged or mixed with the sea or another river. So it flies till the river ends. River stands for the water body ends. Okay. So that long it flies. And dips his wing in the orange sun rays. Dips means colors. C-O-L-O-U-R-S, hot form. Color its wing with what? Orange? Sun rays, that means it flies high, sunlight falls on him, and the wings get colored with which color? Orange sun rays. Which time? Dark. Meaning the dark. Does the wing get really colored? Possible. Hyperbole. Understand why it is hyperbole? Exaggerated, na? Have you seen any But white bird going up and coming down with colorful wings, it is hyperbole, exaggerated. Okay? And dares to claim the sky. And he is utterly free, totally free to say that this sky is mine. Claims the sky means right now, half authority over the sky. He says that this entire sky is mine. That is also an example of hyperbole. Okay? Every stanza you will find one or two hyperboles. First stanza I told you, from the second stanza I will not tell you. You have to start by your own. So have a look at this first stanza by your own and the intro. Okay?